What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. It's been a while since we tackled concurrency problems. Therefore, today we're bringing you one of the most classic synchronization problems, the Dining Philosophers. This problem was originally formulated in 1965 by Edsger Dijkstra as a student exam exercise, and it states that five philosophers are sitting around a circular table, and their job is to think and eat alternatively. Now, a bowl of noodles is placed at the center of the table along with five chopsticks, one for each of the philosophers. However, to eat, a philosopher needs both their right and left chopstick, meaning a philosopher can only eat if both his immediate left and right chopsticks are available. If both immediate left and right chopsticks of the philosopher are not available, then the philosopher can't eat and start thinking again. After an individual philosopher finishes eating, they will put down both chopsticks. Okay, the problem here is to design a concurrent algorithm such that no philosopher will starve, i.e. each of them can forever continue to alternate between eating and thinking, while keeping in mind that no philosopher can be aware of when others may want to eat or think. Now, an intuitive and wrong solution to this problem is the one represented by the pseudocode you see. So, a philosopher will think until the left chopstick is available, when it is he will pick it up, then think until the right chopstick is available, when it is pick it up. If both chopsticks are held, he will eat for a fixed amount of time. After he's done eating, he'll put the left and right chopsticks down and keep repeating this behavior. This solution is exactly the reason why this problem was created, and it's to illustrate the challenges of avoiding race conditions and deadlocks. You see, a race condition is when two threads attempt to access the same resource at the same time. In this example, chopsticks are the resources. To visualize this, suppose in the first round, the second and fourth philosophers got hold of the chopsticks and are eating, and the others are thinking. After they put these chopsticks down, there is nothing that guarantees that different philosophers are going to pick these chopsticks. Maybe the same philosophers will win the race and will get hold of these resources, and maybe after an undetermined amount of time, one of the philosophers will never have a chance to eat and die. Even if each philosopher waits a different random time, one unlucky philosopher may starve. Another danger of concurrent programming is deadlocks. Suppose all philosophers ended up holding a left chopstick, thinking, starting at the right side of the plate, unable to eat because there is no right chopstick, they will eventually starve. You see, a race condition produces incorrect results, whereas a deadlock results in never making any progress in the deadlocked process. In its simplest form, it's a process waiting for a resource held by a second process that's waiting for a resource that the first one holds. Okay, a lot of solutions eventually emerged attempting to tackle this problem, and before diving into those, I want you to really understand the difference between a race condition and a deadlock. So, consider two threads, both reading the value at the same time, then attempting to perform their operations on the value at the same time. They will eventually find themselves racing to see which thread can write last to the shared variable. The thread that writes its value last is preserved because the thread is writing over the value that the previous thread wrote. That's when we have a race condition. The most common symptom of a race condition is unpredictable values of variables that are shared between multiple threads. A deadlock occurs when two threads each lock a different variable at the same time and then try to lock the variable that the other thread already locked. As a result, each thread stops executing and waits for the other thread to release the variable indefinitely. Because each thread is holding the variable that the other thread wants, nothing occurs and the threads remain deadlocked. A common symptom of deadlocks is that the program or group of threads stops responding. This is also known as a hang, where at least two threads are waiting for a variable that the other thread locked. Okay, now back to our problem. And one implementation to it could be, as we previously mentioned, with a little twist. So, we're going to model each of our philosophers as classes that extend the thread class where each philosopher has access to two chopsticks on his left and right side. We also have a method that instructs a philosopher to perform an action, i.e. eat, think, or acquire chopsticks in preparation for eating. As shown in the code you see, each action is simulated by sleeping for a random amount of time so that the execution order isn't enforced by time alone. Now, let's implement the core logic of a philosopher in its overridden run method where we're representing the idea of a philosopher that's thinking for a while and then decides to eat. To achieve this, we use the synchronized keyword to acquire the internal monitor of the chopstick object and prevent other threads from doing the same. We previously uploaded a video explaining all you need to know about the synchronized keyword in Java. To kickstart the whole process, we'll write a client that creates five philosophers of the class we just wrote. We'll model each of the chopsticks as generic Java objects and make as many of them as there are philosophers. We'll then pass each philosopher his left and right chopstick using the constructor we created. And finally, the philosophers we instantiated will be launched at the same time with the help of the start method. Running this code could result in an output like this one. Your output may differ from the one you see, mostly because the sleep method is invoked with different intervals. And if your result is different, it will seem like that solution is correct, but as you can see from the output I got, we still have the deadlock problem. And as we previously discussed, the primary reason for a deadlock is the circular wait condition, where each process waits on a resource that's being held by some other process. Hence, to avoid a deadlock situation, we need to make sure that the circular wait condition is broken. There are several ways to achieve this, the simplest one being that all philosophers will keep reaching for their left chopstick first, except one who will first reach for his right chopstick. So we introduce a condition that makes the last philosopher reach for his right chopstick first instead of the left. This breaks the circular wait condition and averts the deadlock. If you run the code one more time, you will see that it doesn't hang but keeps running indefinitely. Let us know in the comments below if you'd like us to discuss additional solutions to this problem. And that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.